This is an audiovisual representation of a study published in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery in 2018. There are various reasons for poor outcomes following anterior cruciate ligament or ACL reconstructive surgery. Often overlooked is the inherent physiological laxity of the patient's joints. Orthopedic researchers in South Korea wanted to answer the question, does generalized joint laxity affect long-term outcomes following ACL reconstruction? The researchers retrospectively reviewed the records of patients over the age of 18 who underwent an ACL reconstruction with a bone patellar tendon bone autograft due to an isolated ACL tear. The patients were split into two groups, those with and those without generalized joint laxity. Generalized joint laxity was defined using the Baton and Horan criteria, which was modified in order to exclude the involved knee. 163 patients were followed for 2 years, 130 patients were followed for 5 years, and 108 patients were followed for 8 years. All patients had the same surgeon and the same rehabilitation protocol. Data from knee stability tests and functional outcomes were collected at follow-up examinations. The researchers found that the rates of graft rupture and contralateral ACL injury in patients with generalized joint laxity were higher than in those without generalized joint laxity during the whole study period. However, the cumulative rupture rates did not reach statistical significance. At the 8-year follow-up, patients with generalized joint laxity had less knee stability and poorer functional outcomes compared with patients without generalized joint laxity. Moreover, these parameters worsened over time in the group of patients with generalized joint laxity. In view of these findings, the researchers suggest that generalized joint laxity be considered a risk factor for poor outcomes after ACL reconstruction surgery.